Hard work is the key to success, while smart work is the key to excellence. So, good morning, guys. I'm Neha, and I have mentioned that quote of the day for you guys only. So, I hope that you will remember this thing and prepare for your examinations diligently as well as smartly. And now, without wasting any time, let's move on to the news of the day blog for today. So, what we have in this news? According to a recent study published in the Lancet, Nigeria, Democratic Republic of Congo, Mozambique, and India are the top four countries respectively with the highest burden of malaria in 2017. First of all, this is not a new kind of research because a similar kind of finding had already been provided by World Health Organization in the year 2018. So, in its report, WHO had already mentioned that India is one of the topmost burdened country with highest cases of malaria. Now, what does this report say? So, this report mentions that Nigeria is the most or the highly burdened country in the world, followed by Congo, Mozambique, and India. Apart from this, of the total 219 cases of malaria reported in the year 2017, 10 million or the 4% were from India. A unique case was also recorded in this report, and according to this unique case, the total number of cases which were recorded in Tamil Nadu, 71% were in Chennai itself. And now let us proceed further towards our first question of the day. So, which state has become the first one to set up GEM, Organizational Transformation Team Project Management Unit, in association with GEM? So, first question which arises here is that what is the full form of GEM? So, GEM stands for Government E-Marketplace. First, we will discuss about this and then we will discuss about the answer to this question. GEM is the online marketplace which was launched in the year 2016 by government to facilitate the efficient procurement of goods and services by the departments and ministries of government. Now let's come back to the answer to this question. So it is the state of Punjab which has become the first state in India to sign an MOU for setting up the project management unit. So recently Punjab has signed an MOU with GEM to establish this Organizational Transformation Team Project Management Unit. And this unit aims to bring efficiency, transparency, and inclusiveness in procurement of goods and services by this department of the state government. So that was all about this question. But do remember the year in which GEM was formed. Proceeding further with the next question. So the next question is, in which state has the Market Intervention Price Scheme been recently launched? Let us first discuss about the Market Intervention Scheme. So this scheme is operated by the Department of Agriculture and Cooperation under the Ministry of Agriculture. And what is the purpose of this scheme? So this Market Intervention Scheme is a price support mechanism through which the central government procures the perishable and horticulture products in case of the extreme fall of prices. So in case if the prices have fallen below the threshold limit, then the government comes in rescue for the farmers and buys their products through this Market Intervention Price Scheme. Now, recently, after the revocation of Article 370 from Jammu and Kashmir, the prices of the farm and horticulture products of Jammu and Kashmir have fallen steeply, and therefore the central government has decided to launch this Market Intervention Price Scheme. So recently the governor, that is Satyapal Malik, has launched this scheme in Jammu and Kashmir for the apple producers. And through this scheme, the goods worth rupees 8,000 crore will be procured by the government in order to help the farmers. So do remember these things about this question. Apart from this, I have one more important information here, and that is The procurement work will be conducted by National Agriculture Cooperative Marketing Federation of India, which is also known as NAFED. And now let's proceed further. According to the monthly World Oil Demand Report, the world's oil demand is expected to grow to dash millions barrel per day in 2019. So recently, this report has been released by OPEC, and it is estimated that the oil demand is expected to be at 1.02 million barrels per day. Now, this projection is lower by 0.08 million barrels per day. Now, I have one more important information here, and that is, according to this report, US is still the world's largest oil consumer with 20.94 million barrels per day, followed by China, which consumes around 13.06 million barrels in 2019. Now, India's oil demand will rise by 3.2% to 4.88 million barrels per day in 2019, according to this report, and it will further rise to 3.36% to 5.05 million barrels per day at a later stage. So in the year, it is expected that India's oil demand will grow by this percentage to this much, and at a later stage, it will grow by this percentage to this much. So this is a factual data that you have to remember. And now let's move on to the next question of the day, that is, which state has launched the Mukhyamantri Vyapari Samuhik Niji Durghatna Bima Yojana and Mukhyamantri Vyapari Shatipurti Bima Yojana? So these are the two schemes which have been recently launched by Haryana, as this picture is indicating, and these are the schemes which are intended for the small and medium farmers. Next question is, where is Pangong So Lake located? So this is the lake in Jammu and Kashmir, and this is the portion of Ladakh. So this lake is mainly situated in Ladakh, and it flows through Tibet. So this is Tibet's autonomous region of China. So this is the border between India and China. So this is our next question for the day. So the question is, which of the following sport organization has been recognized by Ministry of Sports and Youth Affairs? Now, why this organization has been recognized? So recently, it was found out that this Paralympics Committee of India is violating the National Sports Development Code of India 2011. So there is a long story behind this action of Ministry of Sports that I'm not going to delve into, because that is not important from our exam point of view, and therefore let's move on to the next question of the day. This is the static question from committees. So when was the Narsingham Committee 2 was formed? Before answering this question, let me first tell you that why was this committee formed. So Narsingham Committee was formed to suggest the measures on banking sector reforms, and it was formed in the year 1998, and he is the head of this committee. Next question, how many countries are member of Asian Development Bank? So we have already discussed about its headquarters, its heads in one of our previous morning tales. And now the other question from this organization is about its members. So how many members are there? So it is 67 members which are a part of this organization. And out of these 67 members, 48 members belong to Asia Pacific region. So the last question of the day is, when was the Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency established? Now guys, if you remember that in the yesterday's video only, I have discussed about the World Bank Group, and MIGA is one of the integral part of the World Bank Group. So it was formed in the year 1988, and it has currently 181 countries as its members. Now my question for you is that who heads this organization? Friends, do mention the answers in the comment section below. And now it's time to conclude our morning tales for today. And if you have liked our video, so do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for all the latest notifications. Thank you so much.